Right the other day, I was writing about Miles to Give, and I forgot, completely forgot, like, because I was trying to talk about, like, oh, I think actually I was writing to one of the media outlets trying to get them to cover us, and I was talking about how, like, one of the great story angles was, like, the guy, like, you three, like, how right. None of this was planned in terms of, like, I mean, it was almost like three strangers, like, there were some connections, but the connections have gotten much stronger,
right?
And I was, like, trying to remember, like, when you came on, I was, like, literally the second runner came on board, like, a week before, 2 weeks before, he finally came crawling out of the jungle, and then we got John the night of, and the eve.
The moment that happened, there was a tremendous feeling inside of me that something more had to be done for something that should not be here. And I kept climbing the corporate ladder and climbing and climbing. And finally, November 15th of last year, when I was living in Hollywood, California, I sat in a treehouse-style studio condo in Hollywood Hills and looked down at the mosh pit that I created in my life.
Cooper used to run hard in another world, one of drinking and partying as a nightclub restaurant manager.
Yeah, this all spawned after running hard in a different world.
So how did this group get together? How did this all culminate?
Well, it's a pretty interesting story.
Miles to Give is the pursuit to give and inspire. You know, we're gonna give our funding to Sarcoma Foundation of America to further research for sarcoma, and then obviously, you know, we're gonna pursue to inspire a lot of people around the world.